sketchbook tour. Oh, before I move on to the sketchbook, this is a moleskin sketchbook. I have moved on from these sketchbooks now. I don't find them enjoyable to draw in anymore, so they're not a bad sketchbook. I just found something better, and yeah. Let's get started. I had this sketchbook for way too long, for like about 2 years now, and I'm tired of it. I'm just done. I'm done looking at it. I'm just so tired of it. So I'm excited to show you what I did. Is it finished? I only got 2 pages left. I couldn't do it. I don't know why I couldn't do it. But anyway, 2 pages left. I'll do something with it and I'll show you guys that later. But anyway, full sketchbook tour. The front of the sketchbook, a lot of these are my own stickers. So the vampire girl, Eggie girl, another vampire girl, and this is one of my characters called Daisy the Clown. And I got these ramen noodle stickers at Blix. I like how they look and they're very cute. I don't know where they actually come from, so I'll put something up there on the side when I can find what they are. But I know I got them from Blix. I also got this from Blix. Skies above me, earth below me, fire within me. I love that. Anyway, so I started the sketchbook in September 15th on my birthday day in 2022, and I ended it today on March the 1st on 2024. So this sketchbook took me 2 years to do. I've been drawing in my on my iPad for like a long period of time. So in my first sketchbook tour, if you guys have not already seen it, I already showed like these pages, but I'm gonna show it again. So this is like one of my first pages where I was really, really getting into my alcohol markers. These are all the markers that I have used. I have like named them, swapped them out. And I really love this. I'm so glad that this was my first page. Like, I just went right in here and I'm so glad it came out so good. Like, this girl and her little snacks in the eyes. This second page was okay. I was trying something new, but it didn't came out the way I wanted. It was more colorful in my head, but hey. Trial and error. I do like how the eyes are drawn, but I think next time when I go in my new sketchbook, I'll do it again, but something different. This one. I feel like I messed it up. It was so good the way it was. I don't hate it, but I don't love it either. I'm not in love with it, but I don't hate it either. And I guess I should have swatched out colors to see what was suited, or went on my iPad for like to see what colors were suited digitally, but it just didn't came out good. We gonna skip that empty page. That was supposed to be something, but it never came to. This one I really do like. Is one of my favorite pages. It's like a frog girl with beanies, and I just love drawing eyes. I just love drawing random things. I should have done it more. I had a lot more fun drawing random things. I don't draw a lot of items, and I should do that more, but I like it. Little frog, her little plushie, her candies, her soda. I forgot what you call it. I forgot that Japanese drink, but I thought, if you guys know what it's called, tell me in the comments. This one, I marked it because I was gonna cover it, but I left it alone because I think what I'm gonna do with it is redraw in my new sketchbook and come up with a better color palette for it. It was supposed to be a starry milk girl, but I don't like the background of it. I wish I pushed her hair to the second page of the sketchbook, but the reason why I didn't do that is because I have a feeling that I might color this part in. My computer's in the way. I might have colored this part in, but anyway, I should have went with my guts and pushed her afro to the other page, but I didn't. It came out pretty though. This was my first frog plushie. I don't like it. I didn't like the color. I didn't like how thick the marker was. Didn't like me. This is the part where I start adding things to my sketchbook. I drew this in one of my little pieces of paper. I like her figure. I like how she is. She looks very sassy. She looked one of those mean girls. Then on the side, I was going to draw her again, but I don't know. I think I just lost focus and just started doodling faces instead. This is one of my favorite pages. I wanted to draw this in my digital, I wanted to paint this in my sketchbook, not my sketchbook. I wanted to paint this in my iPad, do a digital artwork of it, but for some reason, I got frustrated and I could not figure out a way to do a nice color combination of it. I don't know, like, I think for the near future, I might just make a coloring book for people just to color it for me, because I don't know what to do with it. I have the plan out on my iPad. If you guys want to see it, let me know down in the comments. But this is basically one of those love heart struck girls. I don't remember the day I drew this. I should have wrote down the date, but I think it was around Halloween I drew this, and I was watching a movie about some crazy girl, and I thought I make a love struck crazy woman who just obsessed with one person. This is one of my favorite characters, which is my froggy girl. I love how I did this. I did a whole video on her, and I love it so much. I love how the markers made her skin, like, made, not, what do you call a teddy bear? Yeah, it's a skin, right? It's plushy skin. I guess I just love how I got the marker to make her look velvet, like she got a velvet texture, and all the blood is dry because, you know, she's a plushie. That's just not gonna be so, you know, wet. It's not gonna be wet. Yeah, I got a lot of empty pages. Okay, so this is another thing I drew off my sketchbook. I have one of these color pads, and I just sketched one of my main characters for a comic book that I might do in the future. I don't know what to take it, to be honest. I just like drawing a bunch of characters and see where I can take them. And this is May. May is a witch who, a very powerful witch that ends up falling in love with a dark elf. And they both are very powerful witches. That's all I got for them. I drew this at my job. I like how it came out. I like my doodles. I do like my doodles. Like, take a pen and just go at it. My little skulls. I love them. They're so cute. They were supposed to be... I think I'm gonna make stickers of them. They were supposed to be for the Inktober, but I wasn't fully in love with it. And I need to practice on color theory a little bit more, because that, I think I struggle with that when it comes to drawing out my characters. Ooh. Okay, never mind. This year was just studies, and I thought it'd be fun to do some crazy doodles around it. I had a lot of fun. I like drawing girls. I like drawing thick girls. As you already know this, you have not seen one guy in the sketchbook yet. And I don't even think I drew a guy in the sketchbook at all. So I just love it. I love it so much. This is one of my favorite pages ever. I took one of my color sheets of paper. I have so many of them, not gonna lie. I took my color sheets of paper and start drawing Marceline. I love Marceline from Adventure Time, if you know it. I love Marceline. She is the best. Like, her guitar and her pants, those are my favorite outfits from her. I wish I have done a different pose where I can show the heel, because she just looks like some these look like socks. They look like socks. And I drew the human version of her because we all know that Marceline will be a black woman. We seen it in Finn and Fiona and Cake. We seen it. And I just love it so much. Fiona and Kate got me wanting to draw Marceline even more. I think I'm going to be doing more fan art in my next sketchbook because I don't know what to draw. And I never was really into drawing fan art, but not having nothing to draw and then you stop drawing for a while, I think it's best to draw other people's characters and just still keep going when you want to draw something. But if you want to know what material I made this with, this was the Gacha markers. It was very popular. It still is. It's very popular on TikTok and it's a really good set of markers. If you guys are interested in getting those, go ahead and get them. They're really good. Here's another doodle that I did out of my sketchbook. Oh, if you've seen like little sketches behind, that means like I took them. I just took these pieces of paper and covered up old sketches. So yeah. Anyway, this is another doodle that I did with sheets of paper with clown girls. She's more like an acrobat and she's a clown girl. I love drawing clowns. I'm obsessed with them now. I love them. Look at them. They look so freaking cute. Oh my god, this here was so much fun to do. I had a lot of fun with this one. This one, oh, piece of art. This will forever be my favorite page. This one is one of my main characters. I haven't given her a name yet. I don't know what to name her because I want to give her a cool name. She is in a rock band. She is also a Frankenstein. The rock band is made out of Frankensteins. And they're in the monster universe and she loves rock and punk, obviously. Look at the way I drew it. And my favorite thing about this piece is this mic. I don't know why, but I love the way I did this mic. I took the gacha pens, the alcohol gacha pens, and I think it was another one. It was like Artex acrylic markers. And I just went at it. I did not think about the shape, which I do a lot. I overthink a lot. And it just came out so good. So good. I love it so much. And I just love the eyes, the lips. I just love how the pop of color came out. I'm definitely drawing her more. I did draw her again. She's like, she was from my Inktober challenge. I failed that, but I did not fail her. I think the reason I failed that so much is because when I like a character, I get obsessed with them immediately. I cover up I think this was another cover up page. Yeah, it was. So I just took all the pieces of scrap paper that I did and just cover up the page and it came out perfect. I love it so much. These are my cute little clown guys. I didn't have the heart to cover it up because they're so freaking cute. I don't remember how the hell I drew them. I don't know how that works. This was like the very beginning of my sketchbook where I just like was just going at it with my markers. And I don't remember how the hell I drew them at all. So I kept it. This was another sketch. I was in this style era where I was using the lightest alcohol marker that I had and start sketching. I was going to cover it, but I like her. I don't want to ink her because I'm afraid I'm going to ruin it. But I love her. I love her. Yeah, this was another one I love so much. But I didn't finish it. I felt like inking it was ruining it. And I don't know why I didn't finish it. I just should have kept going, even though I thought I was ruining it. But she was pretty cool. She was supposed to be like one of those moon, like one of those girls that have the no pupils in their eyes. It's supposed to represent the moon or something. And I love drawing anything that involves the moon. The moon is just a beautiful thing. Here is another one of my froggy plushies. Oh my god. If I can remember what I named them. The other one was Froggy. I don't remember what I named them. I don't remember, but they're cute. They're absolutely adorable. This page, I wasn't really feeling it. I was gonna cover it up, but she's cute though. Oh, this is one of my favorite characters that I draw, and I went hammed on her. Like, I was like, oh my god, you got to be part of one of my clown universe. Her name is Daisy. She's not the first clown I drew in my universe, but she is part of the lore of like three sisters who helps run the carnival together. So this is like Daisy the clown. This was her in her actual form. I like her better instead of a dress. I like her better in these long pants, bell bottom pants. They were much more cuter. And her hair came out of the hat rather than having ribbons and stuff. And I drew her in a chibi form, and I believe I kept going. Yeah, I did. I kept going with the date with her in her chibi form, and she just came out so cute. Like her clown outfit, these pantsuit, I love it so much. Like, I would die to have one of these. I do have a full illustration version, and this was like, yeah, like I said, Daisy the clown. I did a sticker of her right here, and I have it in my shop. I just love her so much. This was another one of my froggy plushies. Honestly, I should have finished draw her. I should have inked her. I know her name was Lily, and she was supposed to be the last frog for my horror lore. But I didn't finish her. That was it. This page I cover up, and I was trying to draw whale sharks. It never happened. Here are some more Daisy the clown. And this is her sister, Sunny. I tried to draw Sunny in a much more chibi form, but I don't know how to do that for her. She is such a long, lengthy girl. She is a very lengthy girl. And this is her pet bear. I never drew an animal. I think I did a pretty good job for my first time. I hope you guys can see that. I hope you guys can see that. This is like purple pencil. And I think I did a pretty good job. This one, I don't know what the hell I was going for. But I was watching something that involves police, drugs, and everything. And I just did a quick doodle over this sheet and just slap it on him. Because I do like the sketch. I do like the idea. I love star jeans. And I think she could have had more potential. But I think the fact that I didn't, you know, look at a reference or anything like that, the pose just lost me. Anyway. There's some doodles that I did here. I was out drinking with a friend, and she drew my sketchbook, and this is her. Her name is Caitlin, and she's a wonderful artist. I will go and put her Instagram on the side. I'm gonna ask her first. To go and check out her artwork if she allowed me to put her Instagram on my page. Anyway, here are my vampire girls. I love them so much. This one I did for Inktober. This was absolutely fun. I get obsessed with characters too much. I love it. My favorite one is the middle finger vampire girl and the vampire in red. I love her. I think I'm gonna have you guys come up with a name for them, because I'm horrible with names. I just horrible with them. This one, I love her too. Like, her whole afro, like, mwah, love it. This is a new character I came up with. She was supposed to cover this whole page sheet, but I got frustrated. I didn't like how it was coming out. I did not give her a name either. She is part, I think you guys have like seen her on TikTok. I'm not that big on TikTok, but I think some people have seen her already. I don't know. She's one of my main characters for some skits I do on TikTok and YouTube. And I want to see, like, there's a style that I'm doing where I just use black ink and just use like one family color, like blue, purple, anything of the sorts, and just use that one specific color to do different shades. It's like that one color marker challenge, but in digital form. But I wanted to try it on here, like that one color challenge. Yeah, one color challenge. I didn't remember what it was called. Oof. Here is another one of my clowns. Her name was Cotton Candy. I believe her name was Cotton. Or her name is Candy? I think so. I gotta look back at my notes. I recently posted her. Like, these are so out of order. To be honest with you, I recently posted a line art short of me drawing her. And I love her so much. She's so cute. She loves candy. In the digital circus, not digital circus, in the, I'm thinking about digital circus, in the carnival world, she is more in control of the food booth. Like, all of the food, like, there's like a section in the carnival world where there's like only food. Like, you just walk in and the aroma of different cultures of food and candy just attack your nostrils. And she runs that section because she loves to cook. Her favorite candy is cotton candy, and she just loves that section. She loves it. She does perform here and there, but she's more in the food section than anything. Just love giving everybody a treat to make them smile. She kind of reminds me about Pinkie Pie, I'm not gonna lie. This was King. He's a very ignorant crow. That's that's all I have. He's a very ignorant crow. I was planning out stickers for the Valentine event. I think I'm gonna do that next year, because I was this year, at the end of, I believe it was at the end of November to December, a lot of things happened with me and I just didn't feel like drawing for a while. So I just came up late when it came to Valentine's, and next time I'll draw him again for it. I just love him. He's just a little ignorant one. Oh, this was me as a clown. I drew myself as a clown with the long sleeve and the cute little jumpsuit. I did, and the socks. I might just make her original character out of all of it. And she got this whole frog thing. I love frog. I blame my aunt for that. She loves frogs and she got me into frogs. So, frogs it is. I'm just going to zoom up a little bit. Okay, better. I just love it. I think I like what I like about drawing with my girl characters is this, the fashion. Like, you can do anything with them when it comes to clothes. I just love the fashion aspect of it. This was another set of vampire girls. They're not my favorite, but they were pretty good. And I wanted to do a skit with them as well, but it wasn't coming out great. I did it in a different sketchbook. Doing a bigger sketchbook can sometimes be too intimidating, so I always switch my sketchbooks. Here she is again, Cotton Candy. I made her hair a lot more smaller here. I think I like this hair better. I think this is when her hair is much more contained. And in the last sketch, which was here, is when she just lets it out. So I really like this, and I love her outfit. Like, her whole outfit is based around the dessert booth, even though she's all over the place. And she's a very colorful person. Her color palette, when I drew her the first time, I was making her color palette the whole cotton candy thing, but I didn't like it too much. I think I'm just gonna stick with pink and purple rather than pink and turquoise because it didn't came out good to me. This was another clown. Her name was Moon. She performs at night. Like, I love the whole clothes for this one. It's the fashion for me. It's the fashion. Like, look at these heels. Do clowns need to wear heels? No. But she looks absolutely gorgeous. I love her. And she's the only clown that I have that wearing this ridiculous hat. Like, this jester hat. It suits her so perfectly. She only, like I said, she only performs at night. And I think that suits her well. And I think I might change the color palette a little bit into purple and blue. But I do like the idea of this blue and yellow. I do like it because of the stars and everything. I tried drawing my me as a clown again because I really did like it. This smile is just giving me Bendy and the Ink Machine. I don't know where the hell I got that from, but it is giving me that. But anyway, here is where King came from. I tried my absolute best to draw crows. I'm not good at realism, and I don't think you have to be good at realism at all, to be honest, when it comes to drawing characters, but I did like it, and I end up coming up with him at the end of it, and I'm happy with it. He's just a little chunky guy. I just love it. I think I have another page of him after this. I think so. But yeah, I'm happy that I pushed myself to draw more, to draw an animal that I wasn't really comfortable with. And we got King out of it. These pages are thick. I'm always thinking that I got another page. So this is when I was doing the whole another thing with the Inktober. And one of the things were fairies. And I was struggling so hard. When I tell you I was struggling, I was struggling. But I came up with a fairy that I liked. And she is perfect. Super perfect. I thought it was cool that if they didn't want to be recognized as fairies, they will have a butterfly tattoo on their legs or back to help hide away that they're fairies. They can change their shapes and size to fit into the human world. And their tattoos, their wings can move just in case if anybody recognizes their wings from the enemy. Because, you know, like, I don't know what's up with anime lately, but fairy lore is very, very scary. Like, people just take fairies' wings and just, it's horrible, just take their wings and make them to slaves or just grind them up or eat them. So I thought that was a cool concept, just to let them just a way to protect themselves, and they just hide their wings. Here's the page where I was drawing King again. These are actual sketches that I did in my iPad, and it came out great. Like, him falling over, he can't get up. He's just a chubby looking guy. I just love him. This page was a struggle for me because I switched to my iPad to figure out how to draw a troll. I was going for something in the lines of Troll Hunter, if you know what that show is, and in my own style. But she didn't came out great on my iPad either. I like this concept. I think I will visit again later, but she didn't came out good. She didn't came out too great. This was just a stress reliever. I didn't know what else to do with my sketchbook, so I just slapped on some pieces of paper in here and just went doodling, and it helps. If you don't know what else to do with your sketchbook, just doodle some lines, make it pretty. It really is cute. These are my eggy girls. I love drawing my eggy girls. I want to draw them more. I just love these the most. They're so cute. They're big ass hands. I'm gonna shrink their hands a little bit, but I love the way it looks. This one actually became a sticker right here. And I want to make another one that says it's okay to cry. It's so cute to me. And these are double yolk. I thought that was so, that's a, like a cute concept. I think I'm gonna do a whole, you know, character page of them. I think I want to do more of character pages too, because that would be fun. Because I love my double yolk girls. I did Crayola for this one. I'm going to turn this. Yeah. Okay. So I just took one of my nephew's Crayola, or two of my nephew's Crayola pens, crayons, the words, crayons, and this went ham. I just started sketching. I think I was thinking of Nana, the anime series, and then I just like, and it's like a mix of Nana and Death Note, not gonna lie. I love it. It was something fun to doodle. I did this yesterday, to be honest, and tried to fill in some pages. This was also another prompt for Inktober, and it's good. If you hear my dog licking in the background, I'm sorry. Simba, stop that licking. Sorry about that. He has a habit of licking his paw for a long period of time, and it's bad. Anyway. So this here, down, okay, this was another prompt that I tried to do where it was for the Inktober, but, okay, yeah. So this was another prompt that I tried to do for the Inktober, but it didn't came to tuition. I was trying to draw some witch girls with eyeballs on their outfit. Well, she's more of a potion, and she was just bare eyeballs. I don't know where I was trying to go with that. I love the concept of the idea, but it just wasn't coming out great. And I guess it's because I didn't look at a reference for poses. It just wasn't coming out good. It was all right. I love the concept. I don't hate it, but I don't love it either. It's 50-50 with me. This page I do like. I actually tried to experiment more with different styles, even though it kind of looks like my old style. It's like, it's different to me because I try something new a little bit along the line, and I try my best to, the sketch was better than this. I try my best, my absolute best, to make something with the acrylic markers here. It didn't came out good. But other than that, I like everything else. I was planning to cover this. But the more I look at her, I do like her. I do like her. She's very cute. She was supposed to have like, not a skateboard, what do you call it? Skates? She's supposed to be like one of those roller skate girls. Here's King again, having some popcorn and a frog hat. And this was not supposed to be King. This was supposed to be a New York pigeon. Here's some eyeballs I drew. On this page, I was trying to come up with a new character. She was basically supposed to be this girl, what do you call those people who work in the airplane? You know those people like works in the airplane, they just, yeah, she was supposed to be one of those. This is her when she's all properly dressed up for the departure, for when she got her job. And this is like her when she's at home. Her hair is in a ponytail. And she has more of like a punk rock style. I did not finish her outfit at all, but that's how I envision her. The rest of these girls down here, I just want to try something. But other than that, now this page. Oh, this is one of my characters that is part of the, if you want to check it out, it's AshantaDoodles Animations. I have a full sketch of her. I was just trying to draw her here to see how she will look full body form. And let me tell you, she is thick. This is supposed to be me. I am not this thick in the hips, but I'm keeping it. I'm keeping it. This is my favorite page. This is actually the first illustration that I did off paper and then just glue it on here. I love this so much. I don't know why, but I do. My favorite part is these shoes. You ever like seen Converse? I really want the Converse heels. I can't afford them, but I really want them. I really want them. They look so freaking cute. Here, I just glue this in here. This is for the gotcha. Okay, so this was just another page that I just slapped on a piece of paper. This is where I swatched my gotcha markers to see how it will perform on black paper. And it does pretty good. Like, look at all these bright colors. These are super, super nice. And this was a page. I love her. I struggled to draw her. I did so many concept sketches of her. This is not actually what I wanted, not gonna lie. But she came out okay. I wanted to do a flower crown on her head. I wanted to take some pieces of paper and glue them on her head as a flower crown. But I didn't like how the flowers were coming out, so I just left it alone. And yeah, it was okay. It's okay. I wish I did an acrylic marker in the acrylic markers, because this looks better than the alcohol markers. Like, it was popping out the page. I really love these eyes. This one I do love. I don't know what came over me. I did not finish this. I don't know why. I think I was busy that day, but I didn't finish it. I love her. I should have finished it and I didn't. And she is perfect. I can imagine a whole bunch of black girls with a lot of hair, a huge amount of hair, running their own little salon club. Like, they're just a bunch of teenage girls, African American, Puerto Rican, with so much hair, doing different types of hairstyle. I think that would be a cute kid cartoon. Not gonna lie, but I love that. Yeah, as we go along to the sketchbook, you can see how tired I was getting. These are just some doodles. My friend asked for some fairies. I'm struggling with them. So if my friend sees this, I apologize. My friend. I apologize, my girl. I am struggling drawing fairies at this moment in time. right here, I tried to draw Rarity, but like I said, I'm not that big on fan art. I really do want to draw all the My Little Pony characters because I was such a big fan. I love Discord. Discord is my favorite character. I tried to do like 3D pose. Not 3D pose, like I don't know what you call this, like where the object is way more bigger than the body that is coming from. I was trying to do those types of poses. I did this short little doodle. I think I was out and I just didn't have like a proper place to draw. I try again with the Crayolas, try to get a little bit of that magic that I did in that pink page, but it didn't happen. This sketchbook did not end off in a good note. Next time I draw my next sketchbook, I'm definitely going to not stress out about it so much. I think that's why I wasn't having so much fun with this sketchbook. It's not my least favorite sketchbook. I think this is sketchbook 115. This is sketchbook 115. And it's not my least favorite sketchbook. It's just that I didn't enjoy it at the end. I enjoyed it in the beginning, but at the end it wasn't great. But I have like two more pages left. If I'm gonna fill it, I'll show you guys, but I doubt it. But this is my favorite part of the whole sketchbook. On my birthday, people signed their names in my sketchbook and I love it. Thank you guys. So yeah, that's mostly it. Let's see what I have in here. Do I have anything in my pockets? Okay. I do have some stuff. Did I sketch on any of these? No. I think I glued most of them. But I definitely do. Oh, yeah. This is one of my egg girls that I drew. And this was supposed to be part of that whole page, but it couldn't fit. And I'm glad I didn't put it in there because it's supposed to be a choker. You can't really tell what it is, to be honest. Got one more piece of paper in here. Oh, here we go. And these are supposed to be mushroom ladies. I think I'm going to continue drawing that in my next sketchbook because in one of my sketchbooks that I'm currently drawing in right now, there's a bunch of mushrooms that look so cute. And I think I should turn them into stickers, to be honest. But yeah, that's it. That's all I got in a sticker. Yeah, that's all I have. I hope you guys enjoyed this sketchbook tour. I enjoy showing it to you. I didn't hate this sketchbook. I give this sketchbook a... what human call it? I give this sketchbook a 7 out of 10. It was a very good experience trying something new. I never fill my sketchbook with scrap paper before, so this is the very first book I ever did this to. And I think I want to experiment more with that. So, yeah.